Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Hello student, in today's session we will see simplification of a Boolean expression by using QMAP. So as I said in the last session, the first question is, what is the difference between QMAP and KMAP? Why we have to go for QMAP? See, in KMAP, the simplification entirely depends on the user ability of grouping ones or zeros. Second one is, as the number of input variables increases, the simplification becomes complicated. So in order to avoid this one, so we are using QMAP. In QMAP, it involves preparation of two tables. One is called as prime implicants, other one is called as essential prime implicants. So prime implicants are the expression with the least number of literals that represents all the terms in the given truth table. So after that, these prime implicants are further subjected to filtering to determine essential prime implicants, so that that will avoid any type of duplication. So dear students, we will see now how to solve given expression by using QMAP. So here you can see function of four variable. You can see here function of four variable this is function of four variable and the SOP minterms are, these are the SOP minterms. So first step, here you have to follow step by step process. The first step is write down the truth table. So this is the truth table and represent the output. So here you can see this is the truth table and this is the output. Now from this write down only those minterms which shows output is equal to 1, like this, 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 this. So now we will call this as stage 1. We will call this as a stage 1. Here what we will do is, in stage 1, we will write the those terms which shows output is equal to 1. For example, in this case, we will write 0, 0, 0, 0 first. And one more thing is, we will write in particular order, that is according to number of ones in the group. So that is one number of ones, two number of ones, we will create a group. So first here, you see output is 1, even though there is no 1 in this one, output is 1. We have to take this one and we can call 0 number of 1s. This is one group. Second one is this one. Second one is this one. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is one more group that contains 1 number of 1s. That contains one number of ones and output is equal to 1. So I will now proceed to the direct table and try to explain you. So this is the table. So here you can see Here you can see, I have written, first one is 0 number of 1s, second one is, see 0 number of 1s, this min term you have to include only when output of this one is 1. So, we know output of this term is 1, that's why we have included, otherwise simply don't include. Second one is 1 number of 1s, third one is 2 number of 1s, here you can see, here 2 numbers of 1s, here also 2 numbers of, fourth one is, that is the next group, fourth group is 3 number of 1s and the last group is this one. So now, next stage is, compare the two groups, member by member. That is, you compare this group with this group, 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 member by member, so that the rule is at a time only in particular, only one bit should change, in a particular member only one bit should change. And that we will write by using this symbol. For example, now you see, I will compare this and this. And here you can see only one digit change. So what I will do, I will write that in stage 2. That is, I compared 0 and 1. Here 0 and 1. And in 0 and 1, only one digit change, that I will mark like this. And I will mark here, it is very important, you have to mark this one like this one. Now, compare this and this, yeah, once again, 0 and 2. Now, compare this and this, no chance, because rarely we will get, because we have written in the number of ones in the increasing order. So here you can see this 0, 0, and here 2 bits are changing. So we need only one bit change. So that is not possible. So now next stage is, so like this, you compare, now compare. Now you compare this one with this one. And you write all the comparison in this group. Try to see whether you can compare and this one. Try to see whether you can compare with this one. Now, after this, you compare this one with this one, this one with this one. So, write all the combinations. That is the second stage. Now you compare this one with this one with this one, first one with the third one, something like that. So when you compare this one with this one, you see 0, 0, 0 bar, here 0, 0, and here you can see this and this is not possible because two bits are changing here. This is changing to bar. And this bar is changing to, iPhone is changing to 1. So not possible. You cannot compare. Compare this one with this one. So that is possible here. You see here. I'll clear this one. See here. I will take first one and second this one. Here you see 0, 0, MSB, you see 0, 0. This bit changes to 1. And here, what is this? iPhone remains same. That only one bit is changing. So what I can do? I can write here like this. I have compared 0, 1 with the 2, 3. So mark like this. I have compared 0, 1 with the 2, 3. Similarly, compare the other terms and you will come to know this and you will get all these terms. So always you have to, when you compare, you have to put one right mark. Because at the end, when you prepare the second stage, suppose there is no right mark, then that term you have to consider in the final stage. That's why when you compare, immediately you put a right mark. For example, here in the first stage you see, I compare 0 and 1. I put here 1 and this 1. And I compare 0 and Now I compare 1 and 3. 1 is already right mark. Okay. Put right mark for 3. Like this. So once this is done, now you have to write this in terms of literal. Here this is nothing but A bar, B bar. This is nothing but A bar and B bar. This is A bar and B bar. This is also A bar and B bar. Here B bar and C. So like this, here also you write all the literals in the second stage, and this is called as prime implicants. These are called as prime implicants. You can still see that in the next table. So you can see here. So what we get here? So here it is nothing but as I said, A bar B bar, and second term also A bar B bar, and this is B bar C, and this one is A C, this is also A C, this is A B and A B. Now you remove common terms. That is, here you take only one term out of two, because same term, here you will take only one term, because you see here 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 1, 3, order is different. Now the terms are same, so take common here, here also take common. So how many commons you will get? 1, 2, 3, 4. So with that, so now you see here, now you make one more table, that is called as essential, this one, prime implicants. So here you first mark first term, you first mark first term, that is A bar B bar, and write 0 1 2 3 B C A C, this one. So 0 1 2 3 whatever minterms are there, you write in horizontal, and whatever minterms what we got, that you write in vertical. Then tick mark here. A bar B bar means 0, 1, 2, 3. B bar C means 2, 3, 10, 11. AC will cover 10, 11, this and this. And last one is this and this and this. Now from this, I have to cover the best minterms, or sorry, best prime implicants that will cover all the terms of the truth table. So A bar B bar is required, because this 0 and 1 terms are covered by A bar B bar. None of the other has covered this term. So I have to write A bar B bar. Now next one is this one I can take, because it will cover 10 and 11. Then this will cover 12, 13, 14, 15. So one answer is this one. So if you don't include this one, then if you have include this one, okay, this one will cover this and this. This one will cover remaining two. So here two answers are there. So this is the solution for our. So now one question is in student mind. That is, I will come to know whether we have to proceed stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4. I will come to know how many stages are there. Now here you see, can you compare this and this one? Now I will take, in this example only, if I take to compare this and this one, 0 year is changed here. 0 year is remain okay. Hyphen year is changed to 1. That means 2 bits are changed. So if you see like here, all are like that only. 2 bits are getting changed. So what is our rule? When you compare from one member to other member, only 1 bit should be changed, not 2 bit. So here all members have 2 bits got changed. That's why we don't have further stage 4. So you'll come to know you have to stop here only. Hello students, the next session is hazard and hazard covers. So in the previous session we have seen different methods like to solve our Boolean expression. The methods are KMAP, QMAP, POS, SOP. In that we will try to get minimum expression that requires minimum hardware to implement, or we will try to get simplified expression that requires simple hardware to implement. But in practical case, it is not so exactly. In practical case, we need additional terms to be included in the expression. Why? Because in the practical circuits has got some type of propagation delay, that is in terms of nanosecond. Because of this delay, there is a variation in the output, changes in the output. There may be an unwanted output or glitches in the output. That is called as hazard. And in order to avoid that one, we add additional terms in the expression, and that is called as hazard covers. So what are the different types of the hazards? We have different types of hazards that are static one hazard, static zero hazard, and dynamic hazard. So now first we have to see static one hazard. What is static one hazard? First we'll see static one hazard. Static one hazard. See, we know the equation, that is y is equal to, that is y is equal to a plus a bar, that is always 1. You take the value of a is equal to 0, a bar is equal to 1, 0 plus 1 becomes 0 plus 1 becomes 1, right? Yes. But in certain situation, a plus a bar becomes 0. This is called as hazard. For example, you see here, this circuit diagram for a plus a bar is this one. When a is equal to 1, a bar is equal to 0, right? Output is equal to 1. Now, when a changes from 1 to 0, because of the propagation delay of this gate, this will not immediately becomes 1. This will not immediately becomes 1. So 0 will remain for certain amount of time in terms of nanosecond. So our electronic device works in nanosecond and microsecond and nanosecond. So for a small amount of time, both inputs are 0 and output becomes 0. That is, we cannot prove a plus a bar is equal to 1 always. This is called as hazard. You see here in the diagram, a is equal to 1 initially, a bar is equal to 0, output I will take 1. Now when a goes to 0, immediately a bar will not go to 0. Sorry, a bar will not go to 1, a bar will remain in 0 only. So both 0 gives output is equal to 0. Now you may ask, why we are getting output 0 here? Why we are not getting output 0 here? That is because we have one more gate, that is the propagation delay is there for that gate also. So output also gets shifted. I hope you are getting my point. Output is also getting shifted, right? So if you understand this much, sufficient for a static one hazard. That is, A plus A bar should be 1 always, but sometimes it gives 0. That will give some type of glitches in the circuit diagram, and that is called as a static one hazard. So now, how to overcome this one? To overcome this one, we have circuit diagram here. You see this one. This is the circuit diagram. So in the exam, if they ask about static one hazard, write this circuit first, explain bit. Then if possible, write this waveform also. Then this circuit. Write this circuit. This is called as this one here. This is the hazard circuit and this is hazard free circuit for static one hazard. So here you can see here mapping. In the exam, better to write like this only because we are giving certain example. So don't try your own option. So here one and one, two groups are there. I am trying to implement these two groups. So when I try to implement this expression here, C and C bar will come. Same thing what I explained earlier. So now this leads to C and C bar leads to static hazard. So how to avoid this one? To avoid this one, I will include this redundant term also. Here you can see this redundant term also included, A, B. Now in this circuit, irrespective of C changes, we have one more term, A and B. And A and B always, if you take 1 and 1, output remains 1, irrespective of changes in C. Output remains 1. This is the hazard-free circuit for static 1. Now, static 0 hazard. What is static 0 hazard? So we have equation here. Y is equal to A into A bar, right, is equal to always 0. Because when A is 0, A bar is equal to 1 and that is 0. Or A is equal to 1, A bar is equal to 0, 0. But because of some problem, propagation delay, this gives sometimes output is equal to 1. That is called as a static 0 hazard. Don't confuse. Static 0 hazard means it gives 1. Static 1 hazard means it gives a 0. Static 1 hazard means always it should give 1, but it gives 0. Static 0 hazard means always it should give 0, but it gives 1. So you have to remember this much. Now here you see this one diagram. As I said here earlier, now this is, I will take this is 0 initially, this is 1, output is a 0. Now this 0 changes from 0 to 1, but 1 will not change immediately to 0 and output becomes 1. That is static 1 hazard. Sorry, static 0 hazard. So my dear students, I request from you comments also on this topic. Whatever I am going to cover, I request your comments because in the last class, somewhere I did mistake while explaining because of certain disturbance or certain because of when I switch from different softwares for explanation, then sometimes I will unknowingly I will make some mistake. So in the last class, at time is equal to 5.01, I said grouping of 0 is SOP. That is the mistake. Grouping of 0 is not SOP. Grouping of 1 is SOP. So the topic was POS, but I explained, I said there SOP. That is grouping of 0 is SOP. No, the correct one is grouping of 0 is POS. So if any correction is there, please let me know, or you can mail me also, or you can write your comments also, so that I can edit the video or I can correct the video in the later session. So this is static zero hazard. Now next one is here static zero hazard circuit diagram and hazard free circuit diagram. You see here, here terms are B plus C, A plus C, and you can see here we are getting once again C and C bar. And in order to avoid this one, I am taking redundant term here. This is the redundant term. So you can see I am taking redundant term here, one more redundant term, see A and B. This is a redundant term I am taking. So output always becomes 0 in this case. Output always becomes 0 because A and B, either 0 or 1, output is equal to 0 and 1. 1 and 1 output is 1, or 0 and 1 output is 1. When any of the input of the output of this OR gate is 1, and rest of the inputs are 0, you will get output is equal to 0. So that is the explanation. Static one hazard. Now we will move to dynamic hazard. Dynamic hazard occurs when the circuit output makes multiple transition before it settles to a final value. That is, you can see in the here, output transition is designed as 1 to 0, but it will go like this 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0 till it settle down. So that is called as a dynamic hazard. So now, my dear students, now next one is HDL implementation. So in the last class we saw gate level modeling. Gate level modeling means I will try to describe the circuit by calling gate function and gate or gate. Now in this class we will see data flow modeling. Data flow modeling means gate level modeling will take consume much space and it is not also suitable for the complex circuit diagram. So we use data flow modeling. In data flow modeling we use certain statement like assign with various parameters. So you can see here various parameters like less than, equal, greater than, relational operations or logical operations or bitwise operations, arithmetic operations and all. And we will use that statement like assign. You can see here. See here. Assign. For example, certain diagram. A, B, C, D is the input, Y is the output, and what I am doing, Y is nothing but I am assigning value, Y is equal to A, ANDing of A and B, ANDing of C and D, and OR. So like this I will use assign. Or you can implement NOR and NAND by using assign. So in the exam they may ask like write the HDL code using for NOR gate by using assign statement. And NAND gate for assign statement. This is the statement for implementing NAND gate and NOR gate. So now next one is called as behavioral modeling. What is this? This is nothing but execution of statements sequentially. Actually speaking, this is better suitable for sequential circuits. Still, in combinational circuits also, we will use this one, this type of modeling with the always keyword. And along with that, if else, all those statements we will use here. You can see here in the diagram, so this one. I will try to explain this one now. Module, some figure, yes, referred here. Input, output, register. Now, always at A, B, or C, or D. That means, this here, when I use always, that means the value used in the para, this one, bracket, changes, it is not constant. That means A changes, B changes, C changes, D changes. Then followed by if statement, if A equal to 1, B equal to 1, Y is equal to 1. Else if C is equal to 1 and D is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1. Else Y is equal to 0. So this is called as behavioral modeling. This is very, very important. So next, so with that, My dear students, I have completed module 2. So module 1 is I have already posted, module 2 is completed. Now remaining is module 3, module 4 and module 5. So my main target is I have to cover this one before your exam starts, that is the first paper, mathematics. So in the next session, we will see some of the important questions from the question paper. After that, we will start third module. That is, third module is nothing but data processing circuits and shift registers and counters and AD converters. These are the third, fourth and fifth module. Data processing circuits, shift registers, flip-flops, shift registers, then counters, AD converters. Thank you. Hello students, just we will revise the question paper. So module 2, I have completed module 2. Now we will see the questions related to module 2. So in this question paper, this is June-July 2018. QM method, we have covered positive and negative logic, covered what is hazard, covered then SOP and POS. Give SOP and POS. Here it is given SOP. So by using SOP, so you have to write POS also. Explain Verilog program structure. What do you mean by Verilog program structure? Verilog program structure is nothing but where you have to explain input and output module. That is, particular module, for entity, how you give input and how you give output, how you represent input and output. Then Verilog program structures contains three types of modeling. That is, gate level modeling, data flow modeling, then behavioral modeling, three types of modeling. So all those things you have to explain. Then design a logic circuits, provides an output when two or three of four switches are closed. Design a logic circuits which provides an output when two or three of four switches are closed. That means here you have to take four switches. Let my four switches is A, B, C and D. In this, you have to write first combination 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, so 1, 1, then 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, like this you have to write. And what it says here? When two or three or four switches, suppose if I take 0 is open and 1 is closed, here not possible, this is 0, here not possible 0, here not possible 0, here two switches are closed, yes possible, here it is not possible, here it is possible, here it is possible, here it is possible, like this you have to write and try to solve it by using K-map and write the circuit diagram. Write the circuit diagram. Now next one is the next question paper. We'll move to the next question paper. We'll move to the next question paper and so you'll see here, this is December 2017 and January 2018, last year question paper. So what are the questions here? You see, first one is simplest logic circuit where D represents the don't care condition, simple. Then this one is Q QM method. So QM method you need to practice, otherwise it is not possible. Practice at least question paper questions. So now, what is hazard? Describe briefly HDL implementation models. Explain the concept of duality in digital circuits. So duality in digital circuits. Let me explain this one in the later class. So now next one is, next question paper, you will move to the next question paper, June, July 2017. You see here, what is logic gate? Important question, how you implement by using NAND gates only? What is positive logic? What is negative logic? And these questions, then QM method, define hazard, all are simple questions. So we will proceed to the next day, this one question paper. Here also simple questions. So next question paper. Next question paper is nothing but nothing. It is December 2016. QMAP, and this is very important problem. Design a digital system with the in which month of the year is one given as the input. This is a very important problem. So 10 marks. You need to study this one. Other than this, we have 10 series question papers. So 10 series question papers, some problems are there. So if you want to more practice, you have to follow that one. Thank you.